Sneakk is special because I know less than a year ago he was working at KFC and he felt like no one would recognize him. He had less than 1,000 followers and shit. I came across his page and I heard his sound. So it's special to me because I know what it means to him.
Can you imagine waking up every day and hating where you're going?
When I was working, I'm like, fuck this shit, but I know I gotta get my money.
Yeah.
But once I stopped working a long time, I'm like, I know I'm never gonna clock back in, nothing ever in the fucking world, bro. That's not happening ever.
I mean, Sneakk has two styles. Coming from the streets, he's a rapper, but he also has a voice. When you look at him, you may assume a certain thing, and then when he sings to you, it sneaks up on you.
He's a gangster. Sneakk is what a regular boyfriend would be scared of, because he could beat you up, and after that, he'll sing to your girl.
You got me going crazy again.
Let's do it again. Yeah, I like that.
I don't trust you, but I love you.
Let me do it again.
But I love you. I don't trust you, but I love you.
Ah, it's almost there though.
But I love you. Drive me crazy, but I love you. And I don't trust you, but I love you. Then I'm falling down in love. I won't give up.
When I hear the beat, I like doing spontaneous things with music. When I started singing on shit, I'm like, damn, that shit sound dope. I know what I want to say, and I know how I want to go. Like, I know my avenues, I know my lanes. I would love to bring the Bay Area sound to the world. Like, that's true music. I feel like I would never run from my roots. My grandpa hella inspired me. He was in the group Gospel Hummingbirds. He took my heart, like, I fell in love with that shit. I was young still when I lost him. And I just know he looking down on me and he proud of me for everything that I'm working for right now. So this what I do it for. He taught me everything I know. That means everything to me. To be right here, if like I'm following his footsteps. I miss that dude every day. This is what I'm doing it for, no cap.
I feel like having two styles, it's like feeding two wolves. He'll eventually feed both those and then just be a complete beast ultimately.
Yeah.
Trippin' wet, looking like I'm fresh off the boat. Back off behind me like a parade float. Coupe cost a 6-bedroom condo. Lit, looking like I'm at the Apollo.
Just knowing that there's a lot of people in here making some creative shit, it makes you go harder too.
Dominic Lord being from Harlem already won my heart, and being there while he was cutting parade, I remember, I was like, yo, who this? And it was like, yo, that's Dominic Lord, he in there. I'm like, yo, this shit's crazy. And he'll tell yourself, I was like, yo, we should put Rich the Kid on this shit. And I was like, we can get that going ASAP.
I was in the studio, shit happened quick. Next thing I know, Rich the Kid here. Shout out to Rich the Kid.
He did his shit. Like effortless, it's shocking to see to me, you know, it just happened so quick.
You know, you just signed a deal and you knew, and the artist like Rich the Kid walk in your session, you know it's real. You in the NBA of the music industry. It's inspiring. It's like I'm right there.
It's a new phone, I cop it. Fuck the top, gonna drop it. Neck good, extra sloppy. I got a ball like 2-3. Way in the hills, you can't find me. I drop my phone in a high seat. You ballin' like me, it's unlikely.
Drop my bitch and went and fuck the bitch next door. I got X's like it's tic-tac-toe. Fuck that bitch once, left her begging for more. Blowing all these racks, got me all in my...
Came together, man. Shit is a banger now, you know?
A lot of these labels, they go for like, the dudes that have been like, 1 million streams already. That's who they run and try to sign and shit. I'd rather look at somebody that like has a star in them. But even though the records ain't there yet, but you could vision like, yo, I could... Yeah, you could be somebody and you just watch them take off. You never know which record's gonna take off of them.
I usually ask the artist, like, what type of mood you in? Like, just now with Sneakk, I was like, where you wanna go, bro? He said, I wanna talk to the ladies.
You can get what you wanna.
Can I just hear that? I think I wanna keep that rip like that.
Mm-mm. Nigga, she called me 1 million times today.
She got a good feeling something going on.
We can buy out tomorrow, baby.
All right, let's try one more time.
I got racks on me, You can get what you wanna.
I hear that.
You should be calling me to check on you.
Well, I'm in the fucking studio, so I'm not.
Well, you've been over here not calling me all day, though.
Because I'm in sleep, because I did 12 hours yesterday in the studio.
I know you on your phone.
Bro, is he gonna call me and complain, or what you want? Cause I'm not gonna answer my phone next time you call me if this is what you're gonna do.
damn, I'm making music about you. You call me, you see this shit? I said, all weekend I make music for my girl. And look what you doing, calling and doing this bullshit. I'm trying to record, I'm gonna call you later, okay? Damn.
Gang, my mama with the pop outs. Niggas always talking all that shit that they not about.
My goals for the second half of this week, just get more hits, more fire, and just turn this shit into a hit machine.
I wanted his voice to be like, it come on crazy.
Come on crazy, right?
And I feel like if he does the hook before his verse, it's just like spray. It doesn't come off like. Tiger does the first and second one. Then he does his verse and his hook. And then YG. And then he fills and ad-libs the last hook with Tiger.
Spray, spray, pull up the fuck up the pace. Wait, wait, you can have that bitch, I got two on the way.
I have never recorded on a track to sound like this. The BPM was 96 or something, 97. I'm like, that's hella fast. TJ Porter, you could do that shit, Sneakk, watch. I'm like, damn. Y'all think I can?
Outside, leave the bitty posted. Let the clip off, then I'll be loading. Now I'll smile, tell me who won it. I'll be posted on the block till the morning.
I'm like, mama, I just got something with Tiger YG. She said, oh, I know who Tiger is, right? She like, who's YG? I said, Big Bang Tate, Lil Bang. She said, the type of money you gonna need to save. You ready? She I look at it like Big Ass Dynasty. Yeah, that's what we is right here. The Undisputed Def Jam, like, it's an unstoppable force, and I feel it coming for hella years. Niggas can be selfish and be like, that's your career. Nah, nigga, I want to see everybody around in the next 15, 20 years like we supposed to be, you feel me?
Posted on the block till the morning.